Hi, this is Kim Bock from KB Saxophone Services. I'm going to show you how we pack the saxophones inside the case and then later inside the shipping box so that we can secure them so that they don't get any damage during shipping. So in this case, I'll pack up a tenor saxophone and we'll use the original Selma flight case to pack it in. Obviously, the neck is off. So I'll show you later how to pack that one. Make sure to use the end plug. You don't want the little octave lever to get bent. So the end plug goes in. Now, the key is that it should not be allowed to move at all inside the case. So it's not enough to just put it inside the case and close it and then wrap up the case. We have to add packaging material inside the case so it cannot shift around. One of the places I see a lot of damage is that the bell flare gets bent down because it can shift inside the case. Maybe the plug falls out and the horn can shift more forth and back and you end up starting having bent down bell flares especially. Plus the body tube can suffer from the horn not being cushioned well enough inside the case if it's bouncing around inside the case, even if there's lots of material on the outside of the case. So, what we want to use is a bunch of this small bubble wrap. So we're basically using two types of bubble wrap. We're using the small bubble wrap and we're using the large bubble wrap. But first, we'll use some of the small bubble wrap. Separate it into a couple of longer strips. They usually have a preparation somewhere where they will tear easily. Alright. So, to ensure that the horn can't shift around, we want to put some up in the top here and underneath. So it goes in together with the plug here. There's a little catch, you might want to come and show this. There's a little catch in front of these type of cases that's holding the end plug and the horn in place. So we have this one cushioned here. At the same time now we want to make sure that there's lots of the small bubble wrap around here so it can't bounce around further. Sure it stays in up on top here. So now it's already a lot more stable inside the case just by doing those two things. The other place I want to make sure I'm protecting is the front of the bell flare and underneath the bell flare also. I'll use another strip of this, run it underneath the bell flare and tuck it in like this. It's also more cushioned underneath the bell flare so that if the case does get a lot of hits, there's a layer of small bubble wrap underneath the actual bell flare so it doesn't transfer so much of the hit into the horn itself. Alright. There's still more room in front here. I like to pack them so that there's just no chance of them moving around, so I'll add some more there. Maybe I'll see if I can use one of the bigger ones right there. Starting to look good. Now for the neck, I'll use the small bubble wrap. If you're using a different case, like more like a saxophone shaped case, it's fine to put the neck inside the bell. Just make sure to wrap it up nicely. and then you could slide it inside the bell so it's secure. In this case, since we have the extra compartment for it here, I'll use that for the neck. I want to add more bubble wrap around it so it cannot move around inside. So here I'll use one of the large bubble wraps. Close it. To make sure it stays close, I'll actually add more large bubble wrap on top of it here. Now next thing is to start checking when I close. I know there's enough here because I can feel the resistance right here, that's fine. The zipper is going to keep it closed. Then I want to make sure that I have more material on top here so the horn can't bounce up and down, while in the case. So I use a large bubble wrap for that. I start right here. Add some on top here. Sort of tuck it in behind a little bit, so. Yeah, now I can feel there's a little more resistance here also. I think just a little bit more. And a little more on that side. That looks good. Quite a use case, not too cooperative. There you go. Now the only thing shaking there would be the handles. But the horn is very stable inside. Alright, and next I'll show how we pack the outside of the sax case to put it inside the shipping box.